Let's see how to build simple C++ programs using the Clang compiler. We'll start by updating our system. And now that our system is up to date, we'll install the Clang compiler itself with apt install clang. We can now check which version of Clang we have installed by running clang --version. Clang itself is the compiler for C files. If we want C++, we actually have to use Clang++, so let's check its version as well. Next, I'll download Visual Studio Code from code.visualstudio.com. And it was downloaded. Let's install it with apt install. Great, let's start Visual Studio Code. And to work with Clang and Visual Studio Code, we're going to need the clangd extension. So I'll just look for Clang, then choose the clangd extension and install it. This extension will provide us with code completion, immediate compile errors, and even code formatting. Next, let's create a folder for our project. And let's create our CPP file. And we can see that as soon as we open the CPP file, we get the suggestion to install the clangd language server. But even if you missed this pop-up, just open the command palette with Ctrl-Shift-P and look for Clang. And here, among the options, we can find Download Language Server. This server is necessary for the clangd extension and enables it to do its job. Okay, the language server was installed. Let's write our simple Hello World code. And notice how as soon as I start typing, I get all kinds of suggestions for auto-completion. To build our code, we can use the terminal. To start the terminal, we can choose Terminal from the menu, then New Terminal. To compile our CPP file, we use clang++, then specify the CPP file we want to compile. And a binary aout file was created. We can now run this binary file, and we see our expected result, Hello World. But we can do even better. Instead of using the terminal to build our programs, we can use the Code Runner extension. So let's get back to the Extensions tab, look for Runner, and install the Code Runner extension. Now, we need to open the settings. So from the menu, I'll choose File, Preferences, then Settings. And from the settings, we need to expand the Extensions category, then scroll down to Run Code Configuration. Here, from the Executor map, we choose Edit in settings.json. And we can see a long list of languages. We're going to use C++, so all we need to do is replace the default G++ with Clang++. Now we can simply click on the play icon, and our program is immediately built and run, and we can see the output. One last thing we need to take care of is compiling multi-file projects. So, as an example, let's add a new class with its own header and CPP files. And let's change our main CPP file, so it will use the new class from the new file. If we try to run our program now, we get a linker error, and that's because Clang didn't use the new CPP file, so it can't find the implementation of our sayHello function. To fix it, we need to go back to the settings.json file, that's the one that defines the behavior for CodeRunner, and instead of only compiling the current file, we want to compile all the CPP files, so we'll use asterisk, which is the wildcard for any file name, .cpp. If we now try to run our program, it builds successfully. And we get the expected result,